supports the regional power in trade market. So under this cooperation, SASEC member country agrees to share hydropower among themselves, to share technological advancement among themselves, and to establish electricity and gas sharing connectivity among the SASEC member countries. Under economic corridor objective, they agreed to reinforce in the existing value chain and develop new value chain linkage between the countries and countries through economic corridor, upgrading the key transportation and trade facilitation infrastructure to improve connectivity between and among the countries, and design appropriate institutional mechanism to serve as platform for coordinating and collaboration among government and various stakeholders. So under this particular objective, SASEC member countries agreed to establish new connectivity and to enhance existing connectivity and to develop connectivity not only in terms of transportation, but also in terms of regional value chain development. So till now we saw the objective of SASEC countries. Now we would like to discuss with the resource requirement, how much resource will be required. According to one latest projection, about $120 billion will be required for implementing all the proposed project of SASEC countries. But till December 2018, SASEC member countries already implemented $11.36 billion for 52 projects. These projects were mainly in transport and energy sector, economic corridor development sector, trade facilitation sector, as well as information and communication technology sector. So largest budget were spent for the transportation project. Total 34 projects required $9.10 billion, followed by energy sharing projects. These were 12 projects for $1.5 billion, and among this $11.36 billion, $6.60 billion was supplied by the Asian Development Bank, and rest $4.8 billion was supplied by the SASEC governments. So resources were determined and resources were supplied. So now come to the point, how this SASEC operational plan will be executed. What is the operation plan, SASEC operation plan 2016 to 2025? So under this plan, SASEC operation plan 2016 to 2025 was adopted by the SASEC member countries in May 2016. It involves refocusing of operational priorities and reflects and upgrade the pipeline of projects by key sector of areas of cooperation. So what were the key areas of cooperation? Key areas of cooperation was trade facilitation, energy and economic corridor development, and finally sharing energy. So refocusing the priority, this particular operational plan extend the energy cooperation into renewable energy and energy efficiency, and adding the economic corridor development as a priority area of cooperation. So under this SASEC operational plan, there are more than 200 projects, and it will require $120 billion investment by 2025. Now come to the point, what are the SASEC priority sectors? From our previous discussion, it is quite clear that SASEC is working with some priority areas. For example, transportation. It could be land transport, railway transport, air transport, sea transport. Any form of transportation cooperation is one of the priority sector for SASEC cooperation, followed by trade facilitation. SASEC member countries agreed to facilitate trade by reducing the documentation requirement, by automating the ports, by integrating the standard and sanitary, phytosanitary and other agencies among the government. So third one is energy sharing, including the renewable energy one. Fourth one is economic corridor development for more integration among the SASEC member countries. So these four are the priority sector to work with SASEC. Under SASEC road corridor, let's try to at a glance. This is the, in the screen you are seeing, this is the SASEC member countries roads connectivity projects. One project was just initiated from Visakhapatnam of India. It includes, it's connected in the Pune and Kolkata. Then it connected up to Dhaka, Chittagong and Cox's Bazar. So this is one road. Another one started from Yangon, then Naypyidaw, then Mandalay, and it enters into India and through Assam, Guwahati, and it cross through the chicken necks, and then it enters again in India, Siliguri, and Pakur to Kolkata. It is the largest. And similarly, Chittagong port, Paira port, and Mangla port has been connected through Bogra, Rangpur, to up to Thimphu and up to Kathmandu. That means this port connectivity provides connectivity to Nepal and Bhutan to three major seaports of Bangladesh. That is Mangla, Paira, and Chittagong. Not only this, this connectivity also linked up Dhaka with Shillong, Siliguri, then Guwahati, and up to Thimphu again. And another rail connectivity, another road connectivity start from Thimphu and ends into the Haldia port of Calcutta. So this road corridor specifically connects Myanmar, India, Bangladesh, Bhutan, Kathmandu, Nepal, as well as India through road connectivity. The five major partners of the SASEC countries. Only Sri Lanka and Maldives is out of this road connectivity due to their island in nature. So let's see the railway connectivity corridors. Under this SASEC corridor plan, number one started from Calcutta and it's throughout the Asansol, Barai, and Rexol and Birgunj, it starts there. Second connectivity connects Cox's Bazar, Chittagong with Agartala through Kumilla. And from Kumilla, it connects Dhaka and then up to Paira Port, up to Bogra, then again Parbatipur in Dinajpur. And it also connect Darshana and Rajarhat, then Khulna to Mangla. At it, this railway connectivity also connects Ishwardi to Rajarhat and then Calcutta up to Haldia. So again, this railway connectivity also connecting all the South Asian countries, including Myanmar, Bangladesh, India, disconnect these countries. So these were the road and railway connectivity projects. But now come to the point how trade facilitation project has been taken. Under trade facilitation projects, we can see in the screen that